Hi, this is Lynn from wisconsingarden.com, and today we're doing a grape arbor setup. Well, we already have our arbor set up, but it needs to be redone. And if you look down the wire being green, you can see that it has sagged down in the middle because it's the grapes and the vines just got too heavy. We had thought that this would be a more friendly wire to use because it's coated, but it's made out of aluminum and unfortunately it stretches really badly. So now we're going to be using a steel wire that's braided. It's a 3/32 of an inch braided wire that they use in construction.
Well, it's galvanized.
Mm-hmm. And we found out when we visited in California that they do use wire. It doesn't need to be coated for the grapevine. So that's what we're using. And then we're using this setup to attach it. So what happens is you put this through here. Okay,
right.
Thank you. And then you put it through, I'll come this way. Put it through the eye piece there, and then you put the other side in.
And do you have your little tool?
Nope, I don't have my tool, but what happens is then you just tighten it down and it becomes a very tight, strong connection to hold up these heavy grapevines. Who knew?
And then come over on the other side.
Now you saw the way it was hooked up to the pole on that side. Well, on this side is an adjustable hook system so that this allows you to actually tighten it up. Once you have it on there and it's been on for a while, if it does loosen, if I can get this going here, you can then tighten it this much. So that's almost 4 inches, really, or at least 3 inches. So let's say you put it in and this is really tight, but then as the time goes on, it gets loose. So you just start tightening it up by turning this.
Well, you can take a wrench
bracket,
or a pliers,
right,
or something. And
until it is tight again. And that way you don't have to keep undoing it and re-stretching it. It's a way of keeping it tight for a longer period of time. Hopefully we won't have to adjust it too much because it is wire now. It's the strong braided wire. But this is another way of keeping the tension where you want it without having to redo it each time. Okay, put it through. Get it through the hole. I'm going to leave about 6 inches here. Turn it so that you can reach these and then just tighten it down.
And it's nice to leave a little extra just in case you ever had to adjust it.
Right. Now?
Yep.
Nice and strong.
Okay.
It's not going anywhere.
Well, let's get it connected down to the other end.
Okay, now I'm on the other side. Here's this. This is called a wire rope clip, so we get our terms. So I've put it on that end. I'm going to slip it through here. And then I have to hook this up. And I've left that much adjustment space on each side. Okay, so that goes in. Tighten it up. Looking down the row there, I'm already caught on something, but that's okay. Slip this through. And be careful because those little wires poke right through your skin. Oops. Cameraman, hold this for me, please.
Now imagine if you were working
so nice. On a high tension line?
Well,
no.
Thousands of feet up in the air.
No, that would not be me, would it?
No.
I'm going to tighten this. Now, periodically, you need to re-tighten these because they do loosen up over time. And if you want them to be secure, you're going to have to retighten them. So that's on your maintenance list of things to do periodically.
Now, because I'm a little taller than you, I'm just going to have you tighten that lightly because I have to go up and re-string
Right, and I have to unhook them from, they're caught over there.
Right.
But you get the idea. And now, if this does get too loose, I can tighten the ends up and get it back to
now,
its
taut area. All you have to do is twist that center collet, and
right.
that will tighten both sides at the same time and draw the wire even closer to the pole.
That's right. So who knew you'd have to do this with grapevines, but if you're going to do it, you learn while you're doing it, and that's what we do.
Well, ours is a learning garden. Mm-hmm. I mean, really, it's things we see that are of interest that we think other people would like to know a little bit about, or at least to get started. And, you know, not everything works, but that's the name of experimenting.
That's
I mean,
right.
that's its purpose.
And we do get re-excited every time we see our plants are getting ready to bud out. So that is so encouraging, and that's what keeps us going.
And this is a perfect time to get the grape arbor set up going
right.
properly.
Yes.
So, and then use nylon to tie your grapes
yes.
up.
I use
nylon stockings.
Pantyhose are wonderful. You cut them into little pieces. They blend in, they stretch, and they're tender on the vine. So if you know people that wear pantyhose, ask them for their old ones, wash them and cut them into little pieces.
You have to wash them first?
Well, no, it might be a deterrent. Who knows?
That's right.
For deer and rabbits, but yep. I wash them.
Okay, good. Well, let me get busy and get these set up at the right height, especially the tall ones, because, you know,
yep.
it's a little awkward.
Otherwise, I'd need a ladder.
There you go.
But okay. I've got you, honey.
Well, we'll continue.
Okay. We're on our fifth wire now. This one, which is well over 6 feet. And then the next one down. Most of the grapevines you see in California, at least the ones we saw, were about this height. But since we have such a short area that we can use for grapes, we are going to allow ours to get a little bit taller and spread them out this way. So now that we have these done, the last one, cut this off so I have extra. That does work nicely, but it does come unwoven. Look at that.
Okay, take your cutter and just cut that off.
Okay. Oh, much better.
Yep.
Let me clean these up here.
Then
I'm going to step on those. All right, and then...
But we've got to bring it, put it through our metal...
Right, we have
post
metal
first.
Posts. And we're going to put them through the holes as we have done with this one and this one. So, back we go.
No, I think the higher one there. Yep.
This one?
Yep. Now, if you had real tiny, brand new little
sprouts.
A little higher. One more. Right there. Yep.
Okay, so you thread it through, put that through there, and then you get ready to tighten it up.
And just tighten it a little bit because I'm going to have to pull on it while
right.
you tighten. Helps to have four hands to do this.
Okay. So now it's a matter of attaching the vines to the wires, and then it's Mother Nature's turn for her to take over and grow. Of course, then we have to trim, but that's okay.
How about eat, eat, eat?
That too. So, if you've enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We'd love to hear from you, and we'd always love for you to subscribe to our video log. Bye for now.
And if you have tips on how you grow your grape vines, we'd love to see pictures or hear your story.
Especially trimming.
Yeah.